Newark, Delaware. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Bob Carpenter Center. I'm Scott Klatskin, and tonight we welcome in new head coach Martin Ingelsby. After 13 seasons coaching under Mike Bray as an assistant at Notre Dame, now it's Martin Ingelsby's turn to make his own name for himself here in Newark. Helping Coach Ingelsby in his first season as head coach will be the return of two players that missed last season due to ACL injuries. Javarski Corbin, All-CAA preseason selection, will return for his sophomore campaign. The 6'7" forward from Tampa, Florida will help Delaware spread the floor. His ability to get to the rim, defend, and shoot the three will make him a great addition this season for Delaware. Also missing last year was sophomore from Jackson, New Jersey, Eric Carter. His 6'9" frame will help Delaware make a presence inside the paint. We'll see Javarski, Eric, and the rest of the 2016-17 Blue Hens tip off the season soon. But first, let's send it over to PA announcer Kevin Linton. From
coaching his first game tonight at Goldey-Beacom College, the head coach, T. T.J. Defar.
Ball's in the air. Delaware wins it. And the Martin Inglesby era has begun at Delaware.
We'll see some good pressure, half-court man-to-man from Goldey-Beacom. They're not much of a press team, but they do like to keep the ball on the side, semi-front the low post.
Love to be sitting here watching some game action at the Bob Carpenter Center. Good to have the season open up tonight. Kasman Hayes is pressure. He loses grip of the basketball. Nearly a turnover. It's knocked out of bounds on the right sideline. And that was one of the keys for Martin Inglesby, taking care of that basketball and not turning it over.
Always a big point. One thing that Goldey-Beacom wants to do is keep the ball on the side of the court and make it more of a five-on-three environment.
6 seconds now, five to shoot. Hayes squares, fires, and the first shot of the season is a triple made good by Kasman Hayes.
Well, Kasman did a wonderful job there of getting himself square. At times last year, I thought his preparation wasn't as solid as it should be. That time, he really was balanced up.
Inside to Thompson for Goldey-Beacom. A miss and a rebound by Eric Carter. Back to Champ Mosley. A minute into this one, and Delaware leads 3-0. Mosley has the ball knocked out of his hands. First turnover of the season for Delaware. And Goldey-Beacom going the other way with point guard Corey Tate. He'll slow things up and wait for some teammates.
That was Corey Tate with a little bit of a back tap there. Anthony Mosley, when he does cross over, has to keep his body between the ball and the defender.
Tate had 58 steals last season, a team high in that category. Thompson's 0 for 1, now 0 of 2 as he lets that one fly from the free throw line after a crossover dribble. A rebound by Chavarsky Corbett. You notice Corbett's still wearing that brace on that right leg.
Yes, he is. He is much better off with it. I think he keeps him confident that way. Eric Carter not playing with one, so we know he's a little bit further along in his healing process.
Corbett of three, and Delaware, 2 of 2 from downtown. They lead 6-0 to start.
We talk about the ability of Shavarsky to space the court. He has great range on his shot, not only the length to get it off over a shorter player, he does a great job with his legs.
18-14, first half of basketball. Delaware leads 6-0. Goldey-Beacom yet to get on the board, looking to change that here. Corey Tate with it on the left wing. A couple dribbles to the right hand. Carter comes out to help. They go inside to Ingram, the big boy, 310 pounds, and he bodies into Shavarsky Corbett. They'll call the foul against Delaware, the first on UD, and the foul is going to go against Shavarsky Corbett. Shavarsky now has worn number 0, number 12, and now that number 1 is available, he's wearing that. So it'll take me some time to realize who the foul is on. I talked to Shavarsky. I said, you've had more numbers than you had years playing here so far. Only a sophomore, but number 1 was his number back in high school at Tampa Castle.
We saw Elijah Tillman at his best there, using that massive 6'8", 310-pound frame to get positioned perfectly underneath. Corbett rotated from the strong side to the weak side. It was a weak side pick and roll. Tillman with excellent position playing through contact.
Tillman at 310 pounds is 96 pounds bigger than anyone else on that Goldey-Beacom squad. Probably 96 pounds bigger than anyone on most squads. He's a big boy, but he makes a free throw, 1 of 2, and Goldie's on the board down 6-1.
He has an excellent touch for a big man, likes to get to the foul line.
Here's Carter, a touch on offense. Mid-left block, backing down Tillman. Easier said than done. They go out to Mosley. In the corner, it's Pinkert. Takes a couple dribbles with his right hand. His pass is deflected and stolen away. On the run goes Thompson. A spin and a layup. That's good transition basketball by Dante Thompson, and 3 in a row for Goldey-Beacom.
Thompson took a couple of early shots, but he is excellent in transition. Can finish around and through contact. Really good in the open court.
Scored 13 points per game a year ago at Lackawanna. Hens lead by a three-pointer. 17-20, first half. Carter inside to the rim, misses on the layup as help came from Shaquem Wilson, and Carter had to adjust his shot.
Well, Eric probably should have gone ahead and dunked that. For some reason, he got himself a little off balance and just tried to lay it in, and there was a little bit of contact. He did not play through it well enough.
Tate to Wilson, who just made the play defensively on the wing. Tillman sets the screen. Carter comes out to help. Here's Wilson, a float shot in the lane. Back iron, no, and a rebound by Eric Carter. He secures it to the point guard, Champ Mosley. 16-51, first half. Delaware leads 6-3.
Delaware has been blitzing. That means hard hedging the high ball screens. That time Mosley chased it over the top. Earlier on, he'd been going underneath. That created the lane down into the paint, which was not the right way to play that ball screen.
Here's Hayes. He has a three-pointer. One of two baskets made by Delaware. Spins off his man. Drives inside. Finds an angle off the window and in. 5 for Kasman Hayes.
As big as Tillman is, he is not a good defender. Especially, he does not have good horizontal movement. That time, Hayes did a great job of sidestepping him and getting to the basket. That's what we love to see Kasman Hayes do.
He gives Delaware a 5-point lead, 8-3. Tillman, baseline J, near corner, off the mark, tip and rebound by Shavarsky Corbett, his second. On the run, here's Carter. He catches the pass from Mosley, stripped. Ball goes out of bounds, but there was a foul called on the play as Corey Tate looked to reach down below and get his second steal in doing so. Picked up the first foul for Goldey-Beacom.
Delaware very fortunate on the last play. No one blocked out Ryan Williams, who's a very athletic senior at 6'4", wing player, came crashing down from the weak side, almost secured the rebound. Delaware has to take a look, find people, and get their bodies on them.
Ridgeway Higgs will check in, our UD Star Health Star Watch player of this game, as Delaware gets back in, reset shot clock, and Eric Carter has it on top. The big man showing some range for 3, off the mark, back iron, and a rebound by Goldey-Beacom.
Now, that's a shot that Notre Dame might like, but early on, I'm not sure that Coach Ingelsby and his staff liked that one. It was just a one quick pass, and Eric squared up wide open, but sometimes that isn't always the best shot.
He's been waiting a year to get out here. He's anxious, going to try some new things. They left him open that time. Crossover, Ridgeway Higgs, back iron, no, off the top of the backboard, and a nice hop for the Goldey-Beacom Lightning to get a rebound. A kick out off the offensive board, and a miss by Tate. Another rebound for Goldey-Beacom. Squaring, firing 3 is Wilson. He misses, and now a defensive rebound finally from Eric Carter.
We talked about offensive rebounds on the possession before. That time, 3 consecutive ones by Goldey-Beacom. Delaware's got to turn, find people, and then go get the ball.
Delaware back on offense, 15-14. Next whistle will bring us to a timeout. 14 on the shot clock as Pinkert is pressured. He loses the ball, dies for it, gets it back. Now on the floor, there's a tussle, a jump ball, and it'll be Goldey-Beacom basketball. When we come back, we'll also see the debut in Delaware jerseys for Darian Bryant and Ryan Daly. When we return, 8-3 is the count from the Bob Carpenter Center, 15-05 first half.
Want more Delaware Athletics content? Click around here on Hens All Access for live games, game highlights, features, and more. And follow your favorite Hens on Twitter for the latest updates.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Delaware leads 8-3 over Goldey-Beacom. Today's broadcast is powered by Brandywine Electronics. Visit BEL.com. And about 5 minutes into the action, Delaware with two turnovers, Goldey-Beacom with none thus far. That should be a number that's reversed in a game against a Division II squad.
Delaware a little nonchalant at times. Mosley got back tapped. Devon Pinkard just passed the ball through an outstretched arm. And here he had possession, and it'll be a jump ball. Delaware, to run this efficient offense, needs and have it be free-flowing, they've got to take much better care of the ball. They've got to make good decisions, and they've got to have it in the hands of people that can make the right decisions.
Tillman gets it inside on the left block, used the left hand and missed. Another rebound for Eric Carter. He's got four of those now. Corbett, a three, misfiring. A tip by Bryant off the mark. A rebound by Tillman. He wants to push to Ridgeway Higgs. No one there with him, so he'll slow things up at least momentarily. As I mentioned going to the break, Ryan Daly and Darian Bryant making their debuts. They're on the floor. Ridgeway Higgs gives a pump fake to Ryan Daly and passes back out. Long three on the way from Goldey-Beacom. Bank is open here on a Friday night as that one goes through off the hands of Ryan Williams.
Not known as a three-point shooter.
You can see why.
But excellent range. Good inside-out attack there by Goldey-Beacom. Going into the big man, kicking it back out. Paris Ridgeway Higgs sharing the ball and reversing it for a wide-open Williams shooter.
And now a foul away from the ball against Delaware. That foul going to go against Chavarsky Corbett. That's two fouls early on for Chavarsky. One underneath on the defensive side and an illegal screen, I believe, right there against Chavarsky. So that's his second foul, second on Delaware. He'll have to come out of the game, and we'll see Sky Johnson come in for the first time.
Well, it's good to see Sky back. He suffered through a couple of injuries himself last year, but really toughed it out, especially at the end of the season. Done a really nice job working the offseason, improving his conditioning.
Delaware up by only 2 points. It was 8-3, now 8-6, and a chance for the first lead for Goldey-Beacom. A corner three, Paris Ridgeway Higgs misses. Another offensive rebound, though, for Goldey-Beacom on the long board.
Goldey doing a nice job of spacing the court. Delaware has to turn and find someone to block out.
Shaquem Wilson with the basketball now, the native of Brooklyn, New York. Drives, baseline, right, fouled, and he'll go to the free throw line. No, that's going to be an offensive foul as Darian Bryant stood, took the charge, and sent it the other way.
Well, Bryant is very active on both ends. At the other end on the prior possession, he almost got a tip-in dunk from the weak side, working very hard for offensive rebound position. Here, he rotates very early on, sees the driver being out of control, steps in and takes the charge.
Mosley brings the ball up the floor. 22 to shoot, 13:34 to play. Daly, corner, three, and an air ball, maybe some jitters for the freshman playing his first collegiate game from Archbishop Carroll.
Well, Daly, also known as a scorer and a shooter, he was set up over there. I think he would have been better off with a little bit of a shot fake and then get into that two-point area early on just to have his confidence get higher. I think that ball may have been partially tipped, Scott.
You're a very kind man. I don't know about that. That was way off the mark, short for Ryan Daly, who is a great pickup for Martin Inglesby, as there was a play on the other side of the floor that Champ Mosley picked up his first foul at. So that's three fouls for Delaware, first on Champ. But Daly, a nice pickup late in the recruiting period for Martin Inglesby, originally committed to Hartford before coming over, changed his mind and playing for Delaware. Now a dribble drive by Dante Thompson. Another whistle. That one going to go against Devon Pinkard. So Delaware starting to pile up some fouls. That's their fourth and the first on Pink.
Goldie's been very aggressive attacking the basket via the dribble. They've been well positioned for offensive rebounds and have really done a nice job of sharing the ball, getting a lot of touches every possession. Right now, this is a very impressive Goldey-Beacom Lightning team early on.
Dante Thompson at the free throw line, a 69% free throw shooter a season ago, makes the first. Delaware leads 8-7. Chance for Goldey to tie things up for the first time since tip-off. And they do just that. Two perfect-looking free throws off the hands of Dante Thompson, and it's tall tied at 8 apiece. Now we're going to see what happens when Champ Mosley picks up a foul or has to go to the bench, as there's no true point guard in the game. Hayes drives his shot blocked, but he gets it back, and it looks like Darian Bryant going to do a little point guard action.
And I like that. Bryant is well-situated. He's a good ball handler. They can also use Kasman Hayes and, I think, Devon Pickard. So it may be point guard by committee here. They'll be able to share the ball. Hayes got into just where he wanted to get, but he did not pay attention to the weak side rotation, and the shot blocker came, and Kasman, not using a fake inside, would have been better served doing so.
There was a foul on the floor against Paris Ridgeway-Higgs. Third on the Lightning, first on Ridgeway-Higgs. Daly will inbound Darian Bryant on top. Brings to the right side with one dribble, a pass to Hayes. He flips it to Devon Pinkard in the corner right side. Takes a couple dribbles baseline, tries to bring it back out left hand. Now he's double teamed, and he's fouled. Two players on him, Thompson and Williams, were both there. And that's the fourth foul against the Lightning, the first against Dante Thompson.
If there's one thing Goldey-Beacom's defense wants you to do is drive the ball on the baseline. He was met with a quick double team. Pinkard, very fortunate he did not get a turnover on that play.
12:47, first half action. Tie score, 8-8. Season opener for both teams. Inside it goes to Sky Johnson. That's a turnover. Another one for Delaware. That's their fifth. Only one for Goldey-Beacom, and a chance to take their first lead of the night for the Lightning. It's Tate in front of the Delaware bench. Screen comes, doesn't use it. Baseline, he slips, and that's a turnover. Back-to-back turnovers as Delaware gives it up to the Lightning, and they hand it right back to the Hens.
Tate is incredibly explosive, has a wonderful first step. Not a great outside shooter, but he has really good anticipation with the ball. He finds where his teammates are, especially in their good spacing, and look for him to get some points in transition if they can create it out of their defense.
Mosley back in the game. Delaware has not scored in the last 4 minutes and some change of basketball. Sky Johnson, right block, working on Tillman. Double team comes. He bobbles it. Right-handed hook, no good. And a rebound by Thompson for Goldey-Beacom in traffic. He took it away from Pinkard and Daly. Now Goldey-Beacom, another chance to take their first lead.
One of the keys for Goldey-Beacom would be how well will they defend their defensive glass. So far, I'd give them an A.
8 minutes played, 8 points each team. Ridgeway-Higgs with the basketball. To the right wing, Tate, their leading scorer a season ago. Stops, pops from the foul line, around the rim and out. Bryant with a rebound for Delaware. His eyes are up, looking to push. He gets it to Mosley. Mosley skips to Daly. Daly will try again from three. Another air ball, this time too strong. And a rebound by Sky Johnson, knocked out of his hands. It'll stay Delaware basketball when we come back. 11:34 remaining in the first half. And we're all tied up at 8 apiece. It's Delaware versus Goldey-Beacom on 94.7 WDSD.
How you doing?
Thanks for coming. Today you're going to choose a mobile office to drive to a remote work site.
Okay.
You can choose this Chevy Silverado that offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, or you can choose this Ford F-150 that doesn't offer Wi-Fi. But to make up for it, we added a trailer, a satellite antenna, and Dolores.
Hey, fellas.
Technology's a little behind in here.
Now, the Silverado offers built-in Wi-Fi with a connection that's stronger than your smartphone.
Slick.
So which one do you want?
I'd pick the Chevy.
Silverado.
It leaves Ford in the dust.
It just can't beat it.
And a goal! It's Delgado with his second.
Delaware 3, 1-2-3.
Delaware! Just like the shot, and that one's in as well. We'll be right back.
and returning from the University of Delaware, number 5, Eric Karchi.
Information period between high school and college.
And not a lot of flow right now to Delaware's offense. Only Chavarshi Corbett and Kasman Hayes have scored thus far. Delaware 3 of 10 from the field, 2 of 6 from long range. And now we'll see what Delaware can do after a timeout was called. Ball was knocked out of bounds. Timeout on the floor. 27 on the shot clock because it was knocked out of the hands of Delaware before going to break. So Daly gets it to Darian Bryant on the wing left side. Flashing to the basketball is Mosley. He drives baseline, brings it back out to Sky Johnson. Johnson with a handoff to Mosley. Mosley points with his left hand to Sky Johnson. Picks up his dribble. Top of the key, it's Carter. 8 to shoot. Hand in his face. He takes one dribble. Looks for a guard. It's Champ Mosley. 4 seconds now. Bounce pass inside to Carter. Great defense by Goldey-Beacom. Knocked out of bounds. And it's Goldey-Beacom basketball. As I don't know if that was touched last by Delaware or if that was a shot clock violation. Either way, it goes back to the Lightning.
Delaware having a lot of trouble entering the ball into the post. They side front. They have a lot of ball pressure, does Goldie. Delaware's got to start spacing the court better. Maybe some slashes along the from the elbow area and some high-low action. That's one way you can beat that side front.
Tate with the basketball. A three-pointer on the way from Thompson. That's strong. Bryant with a rebound. Knocked out of his hands. He gets it back, and now he'll push. Delaware's not scored in 5 minutes. Inside to Sky Johnson. Backing down his defender. He can't change that, but he will be able to try from the free throw line as he was bumped as he went up for the shot. That's the fifth foul on Goldey-Beacom, the second on Dante Thompson. We'll see Sky Johnson, who shot 63% for the free throw line at the strike.
Darian Bryant did a great job there pushing the ball up the court. He had his eyes up. He saw Sky Johnson get himself positioned perfectly in front of the basket. That's exactly what you want to do in one of those fast break situations. A great pass, turns to his left shoulder, tries to jump hook. That was really good transition offense by Delaware.
Johnson can't end the drought on his first free throw try. The junior from Dumfries, Virginia, out of Virginia Episcopal School, misses his first free throw. Kasman Hayes checks back into the game. Ryan Daly to the bench. Chavarshi Corbett's been sitting for quite some time with 2 fouls, and Johnson gives Delaware a lead back 9-8. It's almost played 10 minutes of this first half, and neither team in double figures.
Well, this is exactly the pace of the game that Goldie wants it to be played at. They are going to be a very defensive-minded team, not shooting well, but they've had a better shot selection than Delaware has.
And Delaware team, if you heard the pregame interview, Martin Inglesby wants to get up and down the floor, not been able to do so thus far. You're right, Bill. And a foul, another one, as there was a dribble drive by Ryan Williams. And that's the fifth on Delaware, the second now on Champ Mosley, and that's just something he's not going to be able to do this season. He's got to be able to play 35, 34 minutes as the point guard. He's going to be defending the opposing team's best ball handler every single game, and he can't get into early foul trouble as he is now with 2.
I've been very impressed with the patience that Goldey-Beacom has employed here early on.
High arcing 3 off the mark and tipped around. Ball on the floor, diving for it. Ball pops out, and Sky Johnson gets the rebound. We're halfway through the first half of basketball as Mosley gets it across half court with a 9-8 lead. He'll reset between the circles to Darian Bryant. Bryant with a pass to Kasman Hayes, who leads all scorers with 5. Bounce pass to Champ Mosley beyond the arc. Now inside, trying to enter it into Sky Johnson. A foul's going to be called on Elijah Tillman. That's the 6 on the Lightning.
Well, Tillman was perfectly positioned. He couldn't get quite enough separation to get over the top. A pretty good job down low of Eric Carter holding him off. But the defense right now is not being solved by Delaware.
Bryant, a floater, short, tipped by Johnson, tipped again, rebounded by Goldey-Beacom, and Delaware has not scored a field goal in quite some time. They lead by 1.
They need to also get a little bit more active on the offensive glass.
Tillman, right block, turns, faces on Johnson, now backing him down again, puts it on the floor, passes out, Ridgeway Higgs, fires up a 3, that's off the mark. Hayes tracks down a defensive rebound, a good rebounder a season ago. Cavs average over 5 per contest. Brings to the left wing. Pinker gets up off the bench to check in at the next whistle. Inside kickball as Ridgeway Higgs, that's about all he could do. Ridgeway Higgs will stick that leg out, 5'10", going up against the 6'4". And much bigger Darian Bryant.
Bryant had pinned him down low, and Mosley tried to make a fairly awkward angled pass. Had he taken one quick dribble to the right side of the court and dropped it in, I think Bryant would have had an excellent post-up opportunity.
We'll see Khalil Keel in for the first time, the senior for Goldey-Beacom, as he checks in. Pinker checks in as well. He's got the basketball now with 15 to shoot. Driving baseline. That's an offensive foul as Pinker got a little frustrated and threw a wraparound elbow with his left arm. So he's calling for the foul, and that's his second on Pinker now.
And let's not forget that offensive fouls, one that Corbett got and one now that Pinker gets, these are turnovers. Mm-hmm. And that's the 6-1, only two for Goldey-Beacom. And those are going to mount up not only the foul as well as the foul trouble. So Delaware's got to do a better job of keeping the ball off the baseline, get the ball in a high-low situation, and start driving the ball from the wing, not along the baseline.
Delaware's missed their last seven shots from the field, and they lead 9-8. Goldey-Beacom, a three on the way, off the mark. And a rebound by Champ Moza. He wants to run. It's 3-on-3. He gets into the paint, bobbing, weaving, and the continuation. Get it to him. Champ Mosley in transition, the basket, and the foul.
Goldey-Beacom typically does not get beat down the court very often. They're very good in their transition offense back to defense. One of the better teams in their league. But that time Mosley did a great job of crossing over. He realized the defense was not back fully organized. Finished with a nice move off a Euro step. A really good play to get kind of Delaware going here out of these doldrums offensively.
First field goal in 7 minutes for Delaware. 8:48, first half of basketball. And the Hens up 12-8. They'll go a little full court man-to-man. After free throw
Mosley just showing it on Paris Ridgeway Higgs, who he has played against, so he kind of knows his game.
Two Delaware natives, Mosley from Sanford, Ridgeway Higgs from Hodson-Votek. Tillman has Carter in defense. Keel with the basketball now. His first touch on offense, uses the left hand, and that's short on the push shot. Kasman Hayes on the run, has Bryant behind him, goes all the way to the rim, and Delaware attacking. They've got five straight, and they take a 14-8 lead. Timeout by TJ Dekmar. We'll stay right here as the first season head coach TJ Dekmar is upset with his team. We'll actually take a break with him as that one will be extended to the media timeout. 8:22 left to play in the first half in Delaware. Finally getting it going offensively. They lead 14-8.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Delaware to be able to push the ball very often. It's an easy way to score when you're out of rhythm. A good job by Mosley and then Kasman Hayes.
Shaquem Wilson with the basketball. He averaged 15 points per game a season ago. And he gets it to Ridgeway Higgs straight away. Three-pointer on the way, off the mark, and Daly with a rebound as he checks back in. Daly, Hayes, Carter, Corbett playing with two fouls, and Pinkard on the floor for the Blue Hens. Under eight to play in this first half. Pinker with the basketball beyond the arc. Defended closely. Puts it on the floor. Into the paint. Kicks it out to Hayes. Hayes, ball fake. He drives. Hop step. And finds the angle again. Off the window and in. Kasman Hayes is Delaware's leading scorer with nine.
Kasman, a terrific athlete. Has excellent body control. He can get up, take a hit, absorb it from Tillman, and then finish off the backboard.
Pull up Jay on the other end for Goldey-Beacom. Tipped around. An offensive rebound by Ridgeway Higgs with help from Elijah Tillman. Now Tillman. Near corner, jump shot for the big man. That's too strong. And another rebound by Eric Carter, who's been dominant in that category thus far.
I would think Coach Dekmar would love Tillman to be posting up, not taking those very difficult 15-foot baseline shots.
The three-pointer is waved off on the other end by Jabarski Corbett. It was after the pass from Kasman Hayes, who drove the floor once again, was fouled on the dribble drive, and then passed. And we'll see a one-on-one, as that's the eighth foul against Goldey-Beacom, the second on Shaquem Wilson. Kasman Hayes shot 61% from the free throw line a season ago. That's an area that he'll need to improve this year.
His shot was very flat at times last year. He is a streak shooter. And I think sometimes you get in the rhythm of making those flat shots. I think we will see an improvement with a little bit more arc this season. And there it is right there, a wonderful stroke. I like this move about reinserting Jabarski Corbett with two fouls at the 7:17 mark. I think he's got to learn how to play with some foul trouble. I think it's a really astute move by Martin and his staff.
Certainly going to be a guy that's going to be a key to Delaware success this season. Making one of one is Kasman Hayes, with a back tap by Eric Carter on the miss. Keeps it in Delaware's possession. They lead 17-8. Cavs, the first man in double figures. Pinkard, a foul line jump shot is off, knocked around, and now a foul on Kasman Hayes, fighting for the rebound against Elijah Tillman. Some of these, I love the aggressive nature, but some of those you just got to let go. You got a 6'8", 310-pound forward in front of you, and that's a foul, allowing Tillman now to walk up the floor and shoot the one-on-one.
As an offensive rebounder, you want to always work for position first, then understand where your teammate might miss the shot, or if you're anticipating it, move your body to it. But then you've got to kind of understand the journey's over if the other guy has it. You've got to get back on defense. You can't ill afford little fouls like that. It stops the clock. It mounts fouls on you, puts teams in one-on-ones, and allows them to score.
Tillman does miss the front end of the one-on-one. Goldey-Beacom, all of their last seven from the field, a scoring drought of 5 minutes now as Delaware leads 17-8. Hayes drives the floor, and he's fouled. And that's what I love about Kasman Hayes. That's when I love Kaz the most, is when he is attacking. He's so good off the dribble. You mentioned the balance he has around the rim, and he draws fouls. He's a good penetrator, and we saw it right there.
For a combo swing guard, Kasman Hayes has good ball handling skills. He found a little crease in the defense. Tillman, the big defender, post defender for Goldey-Beacom, got pinned high. He saw that advantage, took the seam, drove in. There was no help by Goldey-Beacom because of the seal off by Sky Johnson, thus an avenue to the basket by Kasman Hayes.
Hayes at the free throw line, where he's one of one today. Senior from Charlotte, North Carolina. He played on that 2014 CAA champion team, and he misses the front end. Back to Goldey a goat. 6:48, first half, Ridgeway Higgs across half court. 17-8 is the count. And Wilson puts between his legs, back to Ridgeway Higgs. Right side of the floor. He stops, extended elbow right, brings it across the floor. Wilson, good defense by Pinker. He drives, hop step, right-handed float shot, no good. Around the rim and out, and Sky Johnson takes it away for the defensive board. Bryant pushing ahead to Hayes. He has an opening to the rim, and he's hit hard. He'll bounce right back up after the foul is called, and back to the free throw line he'll go.
That's the second excellent long court pass that Darian Bryant has executed perfectly to his teammate Kasman Hayes, which sets up Kasman for the quick drive and then the foul. Darian Bryant impressing me with his ball handling skills, but more importantly, Scott, his vision, his court overall, court feel and court vision.
I agree. He's gotten two outlet passes on Goldey-Beacom's side of the floor, and two-shot foul as Hayes misses another free throw. And every time he gets the ball, you immediately see those eyes up and down the floor, and a great outlet passer himself. He found Hayes that time, and Hayes struggling now from the free throw line as he's missed three in a row. Trying to fix it here. He's the lone man in double figures with 10. 4 or 5 from the field. One of now 5 from the free throw line, though, as he misses his fourth in a row. 17-8 is the count. Wilson can't change it with a 3. Hayes the rebound, and down the floor he goes. He'll slow it up as he gets across half court and is met by Khalil Keel. Darian Bryant playing some point guard with Champ Mosley on the bench, at least for the time being. He'll check in at the next whistle. 6:06 first half. Hayes with it. Deep left side to Bryant. Bryant, 0-1 from the field. He drives, baseline, and there's a whistle. It's like a foul again against Goldey-Beacom. They're starting to pile up, Delaware in the double bonus.
Goldey-Beacom is doing a good job of keeping the ball on the side, good ball pressure. They're forcing it to the baseline, which is exactly where they want it to go. But you called it exactly right. They're not finishing off those defensive slides, staying down in their stance, drawing these little sloppy fouls that inevitably are going to mount up and put Delaware at the foul line way too many times. Eventually, Delaware is going to take advantage of it.
Bryant misses from the free throw line. Hens on a 9-0 run right now. It's extended over the last 4 minutes or so. But Goldey-Beacom, as well as they're playing defensively, holding Delaware to 40%, and that number has gone up over the past couple of possessions. Goldey's shooting 2 of 21 from the field. They got to help themselves out there.
And they've had pretty good shots the most part. Wide open shooters, maybe not the shooter matching with being wide open, but certainly the quality of shot in general has been excellent for Goldey-Beacom.
Bryant makes a free throw and then commits a foul on the other end of the floor as Shaquem Wilson was driving right baseline. So that's the eighth foul against Delaware, the first against Bryant, but a 1-on-1 coming up for Shaquem Wilson, who shot pretty solid 73% from the free throw line a season ago.
Shaquem Wilson can hurt you in a couple of different ways. He's has been a very good long-range shooter. He can penetrate, but he loves to play in transition. Very clever, very cagey, and has great body control as he attacks the basket.
And he misses the free throw front end. 18-8 is the count, and Goldey-Beacom has gone a long time since seeing the ball fall through the net. Shabarsky Corbett on top, floats one using the left hand. It's short, and Goldey-Beacom dives for what is a rebound by Corey Tate. Tate brings it up. Neither team playing excellent basketball today. Tate pulls up from the foul line left and gets to go. First field goal in a long time. Over 7.5 minutes for Goldey-Beacom, and it's 18-10 Delaware.
Goldey's got to find ways to score more easily, and that's one way to do it in transition. Tate with a nice crossover dribble in that mid-range jump shot.
Daly over to Bryant. Bryant, a crossover dribble into the paint, tucks it, gets the foul, and it'll go to the free throw line. At 5:03 remaining in the first half.
Delaware's made a nice adjustment here. They've realized that Goldey-Beacom's pressure has hurt their continuity and their free-flowing nature of their offense. So they decided to space the court 3 versus 2 and then attack from the two-player side via the dribble. It forces a longer run by Goldey-Beacom's defense in terms of their slides and to get help there. And that has created these foul shot opportunities as well as pushing the ball in transition.
Bryant makes the first free throw. First points of his career as the Blue Hen transfer from George Washington. Sat out last year, now a redshirt sophomore. And, you know, Delaware didn't get a freshman class last year, but they have a freshman class in Eric Carter, Shavarsky Corbett, and Darian Bryant. And I'd argue that's the best sophomore class in the CAA, thanks to some redshirting that was done a season ago. 20-10 is the count as Bryant made both free throws. Kick out and a three-pointer on the way. A miss by Goldey-Beacom's Thompson. Another rebound for Eric Carter. Now, Goldey-Beacom just 2 of 23 from the floor. Delaware not shooting it great either. Another miss and ball tapped out of bounds. It'll stay with the Blue Hens.
Even though Shavarsky missed that shot, that was really nice team offense. Daly drove the ball after a great transition pass up the court. He then spun back and found Corbett in the deep corner. There was no help. Corbett, a wide-open shot, just missed it.
Delaware just 6 of 17 from the field, while Goldey 2 of 23, 1 of 10 from 3, are the Lightning. 4:27, first half. And Mosley gets it to Carter. Carter trapped in the corner. Ball knocked out of his hand, but that's a reach-in foul, and that's going to be a foul on Ryan Williams. And it'll send Eric Carter to the free throw line with 4:22 remaining in the first half.
Goldey-Beacom's done a nice job of side-fronting the Delaware bigs, forcing them out beyond the post-up area, and then providing good help where they cannot lob the ball. So Delaware's not found a solution to that. Typically, you would want to go high-low.
Carter makes a free throw. Just a 47% free throw shooter as a freshman. Smaller sample size, but he makes his first.
I like Eric Carter's stroke. He's a gifted athlete. He can run and jump. He's got nice touch around the basket, and I think with that really nice rotation, high arcing shot, he's going to become a very solid mid-range shooter as well as free throw shooter.
He makes both of his free throws. Just the way he's built, and he can get that soft touch on the jump shot. He's a good rebounder. He's a guy that over the next 3 years, and it's unbelievable, you see some of these guys that they've got this year and two more, can really be a big man in this league that dominates. 22-10 is the count. It was 8-8. Now Delaware finding their way offensively. Goldey-Beacom still trying to do so, and it helps if you get it to Shaquem Wilson, who averaged 15 points per game. A spin move in the paint, and then a floater goes through. It's 22-12 now, Delaware on top.
The spin move happened so quickly that Bryant was lost on the backside, so this This young man, Shaquem Wilson, very athletic and has got some game.
3:51, first half. We'll take a break at the next whistle, and there it is. An offensive foul against Champ Mosley, and we won't see him for the rest of this half. 3:47, that's his third. We'll take a break. 22-12, Delaware leads it over Goldey-Beacom here on 94.7 WDSD.
Want more Delaware Athletics content? Click around here on Hens All Access for live games, game highlights, features, and more. And follow your favorite Hens on Twitter for the latest updates.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Playing right into the hands of Goldey-Beacom's defense. That's why Delaware only has 22 points at this moment.
They're struggling from the field. 6 of 17 are the Hens. Haven't scored a field goal in the last 4 minutes of action. Goldey-Beacom struggling as well, shooting just 4 of 25. And now a foul against Kasman Hayes, a blocking foul. As Shaquem Wilson put it on the floor, and Hayes will pick up his second. Now double bonus for Goldey-Beacom as well. 10th foul against the Hens. This has been a struggle for Delaware so far. I think when Goldey-Beacom comes to town, Division II team, you expect to be able to execute their offense and make some shots and use this as almost a warm-up game for Bradley on Sunday. That has not been the case, and credit to the coaching staff at Goldey-Beacom for having their guys ready to play as well.
Well, it's a big moment for Goldey, big stage, Division I program. This is a no-lose situation for them, but they're playing extremely well. They're very solid defensively. They've done a much better job of defending their glass than I thought they might. And they've hurt Delaware on the offensive glass. A lot of those long-range threes kicking out. You've got to have your guards dig in and help on that as opposed to just turning and following the ball.
Both teams even on offensive rebounds with 4 apiece. Free throws good from Wilson. And it's 22-14. Delaware on top. We see Bryant getting point guard duties again as Champ Mosley will sit the rest of the half with 3 fouls. Inside to Carter. He loses his footing. Ball on the floor. Stolen away. And now a timeout will be taken by Goldey-Beacom. Nope. They called a jump ball is what we're hearing. Goldey-Beacom trying to get the timeout in, but a jump ball is the call. And the arrow points Delaware's direction.
Well, Eric Carter there made a nice drop step move from the left side of the basket, but was just a little off balance. His step was actually too elongated. Almost forced to walk. He's got to have better body control.
Darian Bryant throws it into Carter. Carter misses it at the rim with the right hand, tips it around, and gets the offensive rebound to Devon Pinkert. Now Corbett, extra pass. Bryant, 3 is good. Excellent ball movement, and it started with the offensive board.
Pinkert with the offensive rebound, kicks it to Corbett. Corbett a little shot fake, unleashes it to Bryant in the corner, and a really nice long-range shot by Darian Bryant, who was very well prepared for that stroke.
Wilson gets 3 right back. He had 47 of them a season ago, his first of the year. And it's now 25-17, Delaware on top. That first three of the night brought to you by First State Orthopedics. Visit firststateortho.com.
Wilson has a very quick release on his three-point shot. Very difficult to defend because he can put it on the floor as well.
13 to shoot for Pinkert. Dribbles his left hand twice. Now between the legs. He gets inside the paint. Hop step. Pushes it to Daly. We'll call that a pass. Daly can't finish on the layup left side. He's now 0 of 3 in his debut. On the other end, Tate to the rim. And Daly with a block of the layup from Corey Tate. Great job of not giving up on the play from the freshman.
Well, Daly was beaten. But he did a great job of retracing his steps immediately and finding a cagey way to get the block on the shot of the court.
Bryant inside to Javarski Corbett. The dribble drive, it was Corbett who found Bryant a moment ago, and he returns the favor. Delaware up 27-17, under 2 minutes to play. First half of basketball. Williams straight away. Right wing, it's Wilson, jab step. Wilson with seven, he leads Goldey-Beacom in that category. Couple crossovers into traffic, no look pass in the corner. Ridgeway Higgs with three, and the senior from Hudson Votek knocks it through, a 7-point advantage for the Hens.
Skipping the ball through to the weak side, a great offensive maneuver. That time Bryant was the rotator and got caught in between men, needed to get to Paris Ridgeway Higgs and close him out.
Bryant inside, finger roll, no, tries to get his own rebound, knocked it off the leg of a Goldey-Beacom defender, will stay with Delaware. And a reset shot clock.
Bryant's issue there was as he drove down the lane, he took off a little bit early, got caught in that midway point where he couldn't shoot the floater, but probably should have used the backboard for the shot. Going over the top of the rim, unless you're going to dunk it, usually does not result in a basket.
Bryant, 39 points as a freshman at George Washington, sat out last year, and now playing as a redshirt sophomore for the Hens. Corbett on the drive, he's fouled as he leans into the defender. And that's an offensive foul. They're going to call it against Javarski. And now Javarski with three, Champ with three, and both have offensive fouls called against them. That's the second offensive foul on Javarski Corbett.
Even if you hadn't scouted Goldey-Beacom and you've been watching this game, you'll see that they've tried on a number of opportunities to draw offensive fouls. The Delaware players have just got to adjust once the game starts. You just can't take off and float in there. Goldie's going to step under. Fourth offensive foul. Second one on Javarski Corbett, third overall.
Brings Jacob Cushing into the game, the freshman from Illinois. As Goldey-Beacom misses on a layup, and a timeout can be taken by Delaware. Can't bring it into the second half, so they'll keep it right. So we'll keep it right here as Delaware talk things over with 54 seconds left in the first half. Now what do you expect to start things off? Usually what you see when a Division I team plays a Division II team is a lot of turnovers and helter-skelter basketball by the Division II team. You could argue that's what we've seen from Delaware in the first 20 minutes of basketball or so. Nine turnovers for the Hens. They're shooting just 35% from the field, 8 of 23. 8 of 14 from the free throw line is 57%. Now, Goldey hasn't helped themselves by shooting only 6 of 29 from the field, but Delaware has not come out and looked like the Division I basketball team that they should in this program, in this start.
Scott, you described the stats, and I would actually be willing to say that the quality of shot selection, other than some of Delaware's layups, obviously, has been better. I think Goldey's done a nice job of defending the bigger, more athletic Blue Hens, and Delaware needs to make some adjustments.
Pinkert in the corner after the timeout, and a foul on a reach-in against Ryan Williams, a 6'4 senior. And that's a double bonus, so Pinkert will go to the free throw line where he shot 73%. Delaware going to need a good senior campaign from Devon at Pinkert. Got to a good start last year, 25 points in the first two games against Delaware State and Iona. He suffered that broken foot in the third game against Fairleigh Dickinson, and he missed some time, never really got back on track in his junior campaign.
I think it definitely threw off his overall shooting rhythm and a little bit of his technique. Always a great off-the-ball defender, a very willing rebounder, a sharer of the ball. I really liked it. I think his shot has improved here. His arc is much better, and I think he's ready for a breakout season. And as you mentioned, Delaware clearly needs him not only at the defensive end, but also at the offensive.
He makes both free throws, 29-20. Delaware leads, 30 seconds remaining. A three-pointer on the way from Tate misses. Good box out by Pinkert. Shot clock unplugged for Delaware as Bryant will walk it up.
And they should definitely play for one. Goldey-Beacom certainly has done a great job here of defending, playing it at their tempo. Delaware will make three adjustments or so at halftime and come out, and I think we'll see a much more kind of connected team offensively in the second half.
10 seconds for Daly, deep left side. Now eight. Guarded closely, double team, picks up his dribble, swings it to Bryant with 4 seconds, squares, fires, and hits as the time expires in the first half. 31-20 is the score at the break as Delaware leads against Goldey-Beacom. Bill, your thoughts on the first half before we send it over to Betty Pinella.
Well, I love that play by Darian Bryant. First of all, there, a shot fake gets in inside the three into the mid-range with a great shot fake. I think Delaware needs to come out and work on keeping the ball off the baseline, continue to push and transition, do a better job on the glass. Watch their drives down the lane, which Goldey has drawn now. Two offensive fouls, get Corbett into the flow, and do a little bit better job of defending their own defensive glass.
We're going to take a timeout here from the Bob Carpenter Center. When we come back, it's the Blue Hens Halftime Report, presented by IBEW Local 313. Benny Pinella is back in the WDSD studios. Your score at the break, Delaware 31, Goldey-Beacom 20, here on 94.7 WDSD.
gentlemen, time now for the second half.
Out. Very impressed with Darian Bryant off the bench. Great energy and solid minutes.
Right away here in the second half of basketball as Goldey-Beacom will get the basketball. First going left to right, we're on the road. Navy uniforms, Delaware in the home whites as they go inside to Tillman. Ball knocked away and stolen away by Delaware. Good defense on the interior by Eric Carter to get it back.
That was a good start by Goldey. They employed the high-low, just a bad pass in there. Tillman could not come up with it, but good job by Eric Carter defending down low.
Starters back on the floor for Delaware to start the second half. Pinkard with the basketball. Mosley, Carter, Corbett, and Hayes, the leading scorer, on the floor. Pinkard dribbles his left hand in the corner, looking to pass out. A bounce pass to Carter. He had no one behind him. Turns, passes to Hayes. Hayes traveled with it as he moved his pivot, trying to set up a three and then move forward again. That's a turnover, and that's a 10th for Delaware in that category.
Eric Carter was so surprised that Tillman, his defender, had gotten lost on the weak side for some reason. Obviously could have just drop-stepped and scored. And again, from the top of the key, Kasman Hayes just a little too quick moving his pivot foot.
If Delaware photographer Mark Campbell caught that on film, there's going to be a shot of Eric Carter posting up. Absolutely no one behind him, but he tossed it out, and Delaware turns it over. Now the second possession of the second half for Goldey-Beacom, 31-20. Delaware leads by 11. We're a minute into the second half. TJ Deckmar making his coaching debut for Goldey-Beacom. Martin Inglesby making his debut for the Delaware Blue Hens. Now on the dribble drive, Wilson into traffic. Corbett was there, but they'll call the foul on Eric Carter on the blocking foul, and that's good to keep it away from Corbett because he's playing with three.
Shaquem Wilson did an excellent job of splitting the double-team hedge by Delaware. If you're going to hedge it flat, you've got to have both defenders lined up just like a fence so you cannot split it. Wilson read that, got into the lane, created the foul situation.
First foul on Eric Carter, first on Delaware this half. Shaquem Wilson misses the first free throw. Wilson, only returning player from 2015-16 to start all 27 games last season for Goldey-Beacom. 15 points per game, led the team in that category. 47 threes a year ago, a leader there as well. And he makes the second free throw. Delaware a 10-point lead, 31-21, 18:50 second half.
Delaware needs to get some rhythm. They need to get some reversal of the ball side to side, set some ball screens, but get more free flowing. That's something I know Martin Inglesby, I'm sure, talked about at halftime.
Hayes loses grip, gets it back. Mosley in the corner, a three. That's short. Gets his own rebound. Pass is deflected as he tried to find Hayes. Gets it back, and he'll settle with 26 on the reset shot clock after the miss. He drives to Pinkard, thought about a three in front of Martin Inglesby, instead puts it on the deck. Stopped baseline, double team. Carter on the wing, on top. Hayes, he'll pull up from three, and that's short. And nobody blocked out Champ Mosley. He gets to Corbett, back to Champ. Short corner jumper is strong. Carter with the tip. Hayes with the tip. No good both times. Carter gets it back again, and no good again. Delaware comes up empty after four offensive rebounds on the other end. Thompson with the drive. He misses. Tillman's there to score on the putback and draw the foul as Eric Carter was standing flat-footed and picks up his second on as many possessions.
One of the most difficult blockout situations is in transition. But having said that, there's no way you can't find 6'8", 3'10", Elijah Tillman underneath. Carter just has to be more alert and make sure that he gets the block out.
And I'll correct myself there. Carter was in the picture, and you're right. He's got a block out, but the foul was called on the reach, by Anthony Mosley. And that's a fourth on Champ. So here we go. We talked about it in the pregame show with Coach Inglesby. You know, what do you do when Champ Mosley gets into foul trouble? Well, 17:55 left in this game, and the only point guard that Delaware has on the roster will be on the bench for quite some time. Delaware leads only 31-24. Reaching foul underneath as Bryant tried to go inside to Sky Johnson, and the foul against Goldey is their first of this half. But we're going to see Darian Bryant. We're going to see Kasman Hayes bring the ball up the floor with the absence of Champ.
And at times against pressure, I wouldn't be surprised if Shavarsky Corbett is utilized as well.
6'7" frame, good ball handler. Bringing the ball up the floor as a four, of kind of a point forward. Now Bryant will inbound, triggering it from the right side to Carter, who's calling for the point guard, Darian Bryant. Comes back to get it. 26 to shoot, 17:41 to play. 31-24 lead for Delaware. Bryant, guarded closely by Tate. Couple dribbles between the legs, brings it from left to right. Now a pass to Carter. He thought about the three, instead goes inside to Sky Johnson. Back out to Carter. He flips it, cross the court to Bryant. Bryant a three, and he's in double figures in his debut with the Hens.
They did utilize a high-low. Eric Carter into Sky Johnson. He was double-teamed in there. He kicks it back out, and then a nice reversal of the court by Eric Carter to a wide-open Darian Bryant.
Hens back up by 10, 34-24. Inside the paint, Wilson, shot rejected by Hayes, looking ahead, he'll keep it. Hens have numbers, corner, Bryant, inside, Johnson, great ball movement, but Johnson, not enough, he gets stuffed by the rim. A blooper on that play for Sky Johnson, and on the other end, the Lightning take advantage in transition.
Well, Sky did go for the dunk, he was off balance, but he would have been much better served just laying the ball in off the glass. Sometimes the easiest way to do it is the best.
If Delaware can get a win tonight against Goldey-Beacom, they'll have a laugh at that one with a teammate, Sky Johnson, watching film tomorrow. Inside it goes to Eric Carter, a foul called against Goldey-Beacom.
Nice bounce pass entry to the low block. Elijah Tillman, the Goldey-Beacom defender, got trapped on the high side. Drop step by Eric Carter. He's got to realize that when the rotation player coming to him is shorter and he's already left his feet, he should just go right up into him and dunk the ball over top or just take the contact and trying to maneuver his way around. He'd be much better served and then send a message to that rotator.
Makes the first free throw. Good free throw shooter so far today, although he struggled as a freshman. Looking smooth from the line today. As Carter has made all four of his free throws, Delaware up by 10, 36-26.
Looks very confident at the foul line. Excellent rotation.
With the basketball, Ryan Williams. Now to Ridgeway Higgs. Higgs dribbles inside the paint, gets Corbett off his feet, makes the bucket, draws the foul, and that's four on Chavarsky.
Well, Delaware shot blockers have been too rigid. If you're going to come to block the shot, you've got to lay off and look for the angle and have better timing. That time Corbett got much too close to the shorter Paris Ridgeway Higgs. He could have given him a wide swath and still blocked the shot. Higgs doing a nice job, though, of kind of finding his way down the lane against the much taller Delaware front.
Ridgeway Higgs makes a free throw, and it's a seven-point advantage for Delaware, 36-29. But you've got two starters on the bench for what could be quite some time with four fouls. Ryan Daly will check back in as Corbett goes to the bench with those four, and an offensive foul on the other end. Sky Johnson tangled inside with Williams, and Goldey-Beacom will have it back with 16-12 remaining, down by seven.
Well, Delaware's big men have to do a much better job of moving earlier prior to the post-up. They've got to get some movement because Goldey-Beacom's been able to sit on their top side, sometimes even in the front.
Now Tillman gets it inside. He spins and gets a dunk. The 6'8", 310-pounder with a two-handed flush. And I don't know if Martin Inglesby might want to talk with his team. Up by only five.
Now, some coaches do not like to call timeouts, be the first one of the half, but I agree with you, Scotty. They kind of need to get out of this funk they're in.
Daly draws contact, his first bucket as a college basketball player, and he puts Delaware back up by seven.
A little zone here by Delaware, and that is amazing for a Division I team to have to go to zone to stop the drives and offensive rebounding of a Division II team.
Inglesby gets that timeout. It's a media break with 15:32 remaining, and Delaware up 38-31. We'll be back in a moment on 94.7 WESD.
How you doing?
Thanks for coming. Today you're going to choose a mobile office to drive to a remote work site.
Okay.
You can choose this Chevy Silverado that offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, or you can choose this Ford F-150 that doesn't offer Wi-Fi. But to make up for it, we added a trailer, a satellite antenna, and Dolores.
Hey, fellas.
Technology's a little behind in here.
Now, the Silverado offers built-in Wi-Fi with a connection that's stronger than your smartphone.
Slick.
So which one do you want?
I'd pick the Chevy.
Silverado.
It leaves Ford in the dust.
It just can't beat it.
A goal, it's Delgado with his second.
Delaware 3, 1, 2, 3. Delaware!
Like the shot, and that one's in as well.
Five domestic missions, including
much better from the two. So a nice adjustment by Martin. I know sometimes you don't want to play zone against somebody you're better than, but it's the exact right strategic move by him.
We see full court pressure coming out of the 16-minute media timeout. Delaware almost turned it over on the inbound, but it gets up the floor. Then nearly another turnover as Sky Johnson lost grip. It rolled out of bounds. It'll stay Delaware basketball. Last touch by Goldey-Beacom. So Kasman Hayes will trigger it in from the corner left side. Bryant, Daly, Johnson, and Carter on the floor with him. Hayes looking for options, gets it to Bryant. Bryant's played well in his debut. 11 points, 3 of 5 from the floor, 2 of 2 from 3. And he's got the basketball working left to right. Baseline, it's Daly. Daly skips it to Hayes, and it looked like it touched the end line. So a turnover again for Delaware, and that's turnover number 12 for the Hens.
I've remarked a number of times in this show that to drive the ball on the baseline against Goldey is exactly the wrong thing to do. It works against other teams, but they sink their players on the weak side. It makes that throw through to the deep corner very difficult. That time Daly bounced it out of bounds.
It's been a well-coached basketball team, Goldey-Beacom. TJ Deckmar in his debut. Lee Sibley, top assistant, former head coach of St. Mark's. But Goldey's looked good. Hayes got his hand on the basketball. Thought it might have touched Paris Ridgeway Higgs after the initial deflection, but they'll say it did not. Kasman Hayes will knock it out, and it'll stay Goldey basketball with 15 to shoot, 15 minutes to play exactly, and the score 38-31 Hens.
Delaware in a 2-3 zone. Kasman Hayes and Darian Bryan up top. That provides them with some nice length up top, but their bottom line's got to do a good job here of blocking out in the zone.
Shot for three is good from Goldey-Beacom. They shot just 3 of 15 in the first half, make their first try of the second half. It was Shaquem Wilson who has this game down to 4 points, 38-34. Delaware with the lead in the basketball. Carter slips, passes to Hayes. Hayes, cross court to Carter. Carter a ball fake, gets to the foul line, inside to Daly. Daly working on a bigger defender. Passes out to Hayes. Hayes slicing through, contact, no whistle. Ball deflected, he gets it back. Shot blocked, but a foul.
We talked about the lack of mobility earlier in the game by Elijah Tillman, but when you challenge him directly and he's positioned properly, he does a nice job of going straight up with his arms right next to his ears, which gives him the principle of verticality where he won't foul, and that big body acts as a wall, and Delaware's had trouble scoring, though Ryan Daly, two possessions ago, did a really nice job of finishing over top.
That time, Corey Tate was called for the foul. That's the second on him, the second on Goldey-Beacom. And Kasman Hayes made his first free throw, and after that miss, he has now missed his last five. He is 1 of 6 from the free throw line after that miss. Hayes shot just 61% from the free throw line a season ago. Did score 11 points per game, but Hayes is going to get to the free throw line this season in his senior campaign, so he's going to have to knock these down. He ends the streak of misses with his second try, and Delaware up by 5, 39-34.
Delaware will continue to fall back into this 2-3 zone. Now they're going to need to locate shooters.
They've got Pinkert on top with Kasman Hayes. Bryant defending as there's a drive by Tate. Tate baseline. Pass to Lawson, who just checked in. Lawson with a miss on his first try of the evening. Bryant with a rebound, knocked out of his hands, but out of bounds baseline. Last touch by Ryan Williams. It'll stay Delaware basketball.
A nice defensive rebound on the weak side by Bryant, though once he secured the ball, he kind of curled up over top of it, allowed it almost to be knocked out. Just get the ball under your chin and get your elbows out, and you'll be fine.
And shooting is 2 of 8 this half, with the basketball up 5, 13-48. Left to play at the Bob. Hayes drives on Lawson, who just missed on the other end, and the foul is called on the dribble drive. That's just the third on the Lightning. So Delaware will inbound.
Nick Lawson, a senior, a transfer from Tekio Post within the CACC League. A good defender that time, though he let Hayes get over the top of him. One of Goldey-Beacom's tenets is keep the ball on the side.
Hayes gets it into Bryant with some pressure by Tate. Tate, a good defender, had 58 steals a season ago to lead the team. Daly on the wing, left side, back on top to Bryant. They'll work it around. Corner, Pinkert. He drives baseline, powers up, misses the gimme underneath. It's back tap, reset shot clock to Hayes. Pinkert gets it back on the wing. Right side in front of Delaware's bench. Inside to Sky Johnson, and a traveling violation is turnover number 13 for Delaware. In contrast, only 4 for the Division II Goldey-Beacom Lightning.
Sky Johnson just a little too eager. He might have been better served facing up against Tillman. I think that would be the right move to play him. He backed down. Tillman had given him some space, and that created the walk.
Delaware has a team looking a little too eager, opening up the season on their new head coach, Martin Ingelsby. Tate a 3. We got a ball game, Bill. 39-37. Delaware's lead cut to two.
And that was not bad defense by Darian Bryant. He had a high hand contest, just a better offensive play.
Three-pointer, the first of the night from Tate. Now the ball is deflected. Quick hands by Bill as it comes our way. And with 12:58 remaining, the momentum on the side of the Lightning right now.
Boy, it sure is. And this is how we're going to find out early on that Delaware, how they're going to react to this. Martin Inglesby will really have to dig down deep. At some point, he may have to reinsert Corbett or Anthony Mosley, who both are saddled with four fouls at the moment.
And they picked up, both of those players picked up their fourth foul early this half. Daly slicing through, gets a pass, loses his dribble to Pinker now. He gets around Tillman, loses his feet, dumps it off to Johnson. Johnson finishes it with the left. Great decision at the last moment by Devon Pinker to find his teammate.
I've always been impressed with Pinkert's willingness to share the basketball. A good off-the-ball defender does a lot of the little things that aren't always noticed. That time, a wonderful find on the weak side.
Now Sky Johnson with a steal, nearly taken right back by Goldey-Beacom. On the other end, it's Hayes crashing into Tillman. That's an offensive foul, as we've talked about the ability of Elijah Tillman to go straight up and draw the charge.
Well, Tillman was situated just outside the arc. He recognized what Hayes was going to do, and he just stood his ground. And Kasman there would have been better off pulling up, taking that mid-range shot, which he is very good at, instead of forcing the action.
So third on Kasman Hayes, six on Delaware. Next foul will put Goldey-Beacom at the free throw line, where they're 3 of 4 this half, 8 of 12 overall. Delaware up 41-37, a jab set by Wilson, now a pass right wing, Ridgeway Higgs, corner, it goes to Keel. Keel, who just checked in, passes to Ridgeway Higgs, a three on the way, off the mark, good box out by Daly, and a rebound by the freshman from Archbishop Carroll.
Another good look, though, from the three-point line by Paris Ridgeway Higgs. If he's left open, he will eventually knock that shot down, a great preseason shooting.
Hayes to Bryant. Left side to Pinkert. Pinkert driving baseline this time on the left. Pulls up, floater, no good. Tipped around, and Wilson, I believe, touched that last. No, they'll say Daly got his hand on it. It'll be Goldey-Beacom with the basketball, down four when we come back. We'll take a break with 11:43 remaining from the Bob Carpenter Center in Delaware. Up 41-37 on 94.7 WDSD.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Great to see that cockpit full of Delaware students to start things off as Delaware trying to get a win for these fans. Up 41-37, closer than many anticipated in the opening against Division II Goldey-Beacom. This is the first time Delaware's played a Division II team as Keel knocks down the three from straight away since 1997. It's 41-40. We'll see full court pressure against Delaware, playing without their point guard, Champ Mosley. And Ryan Daly going to try to bring the ball up the floor. He loses his dribble. Hens get it across. Hayes inside. Carter left all alone as the Hens break pressure and get a layup.
And a good job by Ryan Daly, not playing too fast. You know you're going to see pressure from Goldey-Beacom without Mosley and others in the ball game. Good composure, turning Eric Carter, finding his way wide open underneath the basket. A good find there by Kasman Hayes.
An easy call on the other end as Pinkert bumped into Shaquem Wilson, puts Wilson on the line for a 1-on-1, 73% free throw shooter a season ago. 3 of 5 today. That's the third on Devon Pinkert. So you look at this Delaware team, you've got 3 on Pinkert, 3 on Hayes, 4 on Corbett and Mosley. And in fact, that's the 6th foul. They had 6 up a little early on the scoreboard here. So no 1-and-1. It'll be possession, Goldey-Beacom. Ingram with it. Mid-left block. Working on Carter. Carter drops, takes the charge, and we're going the other way.
Eric Carter did a great job there of positioning himself on the left shoulder, which enabled him to draw the charge as Tillman forced his way in. Tillman, once he feels that top pressure, should have immediately picked up the ball and drop step, and he would have had a basket. There was no help from Delaware underneath. Delaware has switched from that zone that we talked about earlier on in the half back to their man-to-man.
Ends up by 3, 43-40, 10:47. Second half, Carter in the corner. No look to a cutting Bryant. He powers up in an offensive foul going back the other way. That's turnover number 15 for Delaware. The Hens averaged 12 per game a season ago, and there's 10:43 left in this one.
And if I'm not mistaken, Scott, that might be the 6th offensive foul that's been called. 4 of the true charges. One was an over-the-back. Another one was a moving screen by Shabarsky Corbett. But too many mistakes here. Martin Inglesby and his staff will clean it up here by Bradley on Sunday.
That's the 2nd foul on Darian Bryant. That's a 7th team foul now officially for the Hens, but on the offensive, you don't shoot free throws. So Goldey-Beacom with the basketball, a chance to tie this score down by 3. Instead, they go inside to Ingram and back down 1. Go the Lightning, 43-42.
Well, they called Eric Carter and a help up there. And Tillman, very cagey, finishing underneath, using the rim as a shot block protector.
Martin Inglesby wants to talk to his team. We'll take a break with Coach Inglesby and the Hens with 10:14 remaining in the second half. And the Hens up only 1, 43-42.
From the beautiful Delaware coastline to the busy streets of Wilmington, it's easy to see that even within our 96 miles, Delaware has a wide variety of people. That's why when you're looking for great rates on insurance, you should trust the local agent. Ann Sharp from your GEICO local office knows Delaware. And that's why when you need insurance, you can trust Ann and her team of professionals. Call Ann Sharp at your GEICO local office Delaware today for a quote.
Play it possession by possession, inch ahead, get a couple of defensive stops, and get back into the flow of the game. And I wouldn't be surprised if anytime soon. And Corbett back in the game, a good substitution here by Martin Inglesby.
He's playing with the 4 fouls in the game. Corbett with 5 points tonight. Daly with the basketball as he resume action. Corbett off the bench, and he misses on a 3. Rebound on the offensive glass by Eric Carter. Put back is through, and Delaware back up 3.
One of the big worries of the Goldey-Beacom staff was Delaware hurting them on the offensive glass. A really nice shot by Corbett, and Eric Carter was positioned perfectly for them and lays it back in. Did a nice job of blocking out Tillman.
10th rebound of the night for Eric Carter, the first in double figures in that category. And now the Hens will defend with 9:33 remaining in this one. It's Tate, dribbles between the legs, stops the foul line. Up off the mark, Daly another rebound as he crashes. He'll look to push. Cross half court, Daly
finds Hayes. Hayes open for a three, and five in a row after the timeout taken by Martin Inglesby.
A great timeout, and I think Goldey should counter with a timeout right here before this game slips away.
Great job by Delaware getting the timeout, focusing, regrouping, like you said, and getting on a little bit of a run. Here with 9 minutes left, the lead extends to 48-42. Tillman with the basketball, one dribble back to the guard. It's Ryan Williams, a transfer from Georgetown where he walked on. He drives. An odd-looking shot as he had to adjust in midair, but he gets it to go from the free throw line. And this lead back to four for Delaware now.
A very creative way to finish on that shot. He actually had to double clutch it and then move it further out to the right due to the shot blocking. But good defense there by Delaware.
Hayes, can he do it again from three? In and out. And a rebound by Tillman. And a whistle away from the ball. There's a man down. I believe it's Corey Tate. Nope, excuse me. That's Ryan Williams, who's along the baseline. He's stretching things out. Perhaps a cramp by Ryan Williams. Williams, the son of Reggie Williams, who won a championship at Georgetown in 1984, played in the NBA, the fourth pick overall in 1987. And Williams went to Georgetown, wanted to play some ball like his dad, walked onto the team, and obviously hard to get some minutes at Georgetown as a Hoya, so he decided to transfer. Now a pivotal part of this Goldey-Beacom team this year, playing his senior season with the Lightning.
What a great find for Goldey-Beacom. He is a graduate student working on his business master's. Great lineage, as you already described. Very active player, attended Archbishop Carroll in Washington, D.C., in that excellent Catholic league. And a player that's got a lot of dimensions to his game, and a terrific find by Coach Detmar in his first season. And I've been told that he's very active at both ends of the court and a really good defender that's fit into the defensive scheme of Goldey-Beacom.
And he seemed to be okay, was stretched out and ran to the bench on his own strength. And now play resumes with 8:19. Kickball by Ryan Daly as he was defending Ridgeway Higgs, who brought the ball up the floor. 48-44 is Delaware's lead. And the inbound by Ridgeway Higgs. And here is bench head coach TJ Detmar, his coaching debut, as it is for Martin Inglesby of Delaware. 15 to shoot. Wilson, a crossover. Dribbling in on Bryant. Spins, kicks out. Tate on the dribble drive. The shot from Nick Lawson is good for three. Again, it's a one-point game. The Lightning just won't go away.
I was about ready to remark that Goldey should run a clear out for Lawson because he was being defended by Shavarsky Corbett, and instead he gets a wide-open three. Corbett did not even attempt to contest that shot.
Corbett playing with four. Daly drives. Hayes from the baseline. Kick out. Bryant thought about a three and said puts it on the floor. Dumps it into Carter. That's an offensive foul, and Goldey-Beacom takes yet another charge on the defensive end.
Well, that's really good coaching. Coach Detmar, Coach Sibley, Coach Epstein, and others, they're just willing to say, you drive and leave your feet, we're going to step under. And that's just excellent defense. That's how you stop teams who wildly penetrate. That's what I thought Martin was telling them at the last timeout.
That's turnover number 16, and that brings us to another timeout. 7:41 remaining, and a one-point lead in the season opener for the Hens.
Want more Delaware Athletics content? Click around here on Hens All Access for live games, game highlights, features, and more. And follow your favorite Hens on Twitter for the latest updates.
It's your turn to mix it up at Mickey D's. For a limited time, choose any two. From mouth-watering new picks to tasty classics. McPick 2 for $5. Enjoy the choice.
Rush hour or relax hour, it's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
Set and Harrisonbury, Chase Madison 2, Delaware 4.
when they see the tape, they'll find ways to eliminate half of the fouls they've gotten. That's by being out of control, leaving their feet too early, play off a jump stop as opposed to the single-footed jump. And they'll correct those mistakes. But Delaware's got to be really tough here mentally in this last 7:24.
Goldey-Beacom has never led in this contest. Tate with the basketball, 9 to shoot, near half court. It's Lawson, 6 seconds, now 5. Tate with 4, 3 seconds, a crossover, a 3 on the way. That's short, good defense by Darian Bryant. 11th rebound of the game for Eric Carter, and the Hens can extend their lead. Mosley playing with 4 fouls, back in the game. Bryant in the corner, will bring it back out, or at least try to. Wilson, good defense. Extended foul line right is Carter. Calling for a guard. Gets it to Bryant. 16 to shoot. Cross court pass is stolen away. Not a good pass by Bryant. And another chance for Goldey-Beacom. They're on the run. Ridgeway Higgs. Bounce pass to Wilson. Left wing. Mosley in defense. Ridgeway Higgs has a catch with Wilson. Inside. It goes to Thompson. Thompson sitting for a long time with 4 fouls himself. Gets Carter in the air. Kicks out to Wilson. Wilson a 3. Off the mark. Deflection. Rebound Ridgeway Higgs. And now Tate will reset.
Boy, what a nice possession by Goldey-Beacom. A wonderful shot from the top of the key that was wide open. Mosley too slow to close out Wilson. And then good composure here after the miss.
Tate's jump shot off the mark. And another missed opportunity to take their first lead for Goldey-Beacom. They're 0 of 2 possessions, down by 1. And the Hens get it back.
Delaware needs to run some more movement offense here. That was kind of the hallmark of what they wanted to do, get better spacing. But just hasn't been enough off-the-ball movement by Delaware.
Here's Carter down low. Soft touch from the big man. And Delaware up by 3.
That was a clear to the weak side. A nice entry pass. Eric Carter took his time moving in. A nice power jump hook over the much shorter Thompson.
A jumper by Ridgeway. Higgs gets 2 right back, and there has been an answer every time by Goldey-Beacom College. They're down 50-49. TJ Dekmar wants to talk with his crew, and we'll stay right here as that's a 30-second timeout. Nothing great was built on an empty stomach. Dash In now offers all-new breakfast sandwiches on a warm, buttery croissant roll. Grab a 16-ounce Dash In coffee and a breakfast sandwich for only $3.50. We'll be grabbing some Dash In coffee and breakfast sandwiches on our way down to Richmond tomorrow as Delaware takes on the Richmond Spiders. We're heading down there early. Myself and Matt Janis on the call. Michael Attenrasse on the sideline. Hens winners of 2 games in a row on the football field. They'll take on number 8 Richmond. Pregame begins at 2:30 and kickoff at 3:30 against the Spiders right here on 94.7 WDSD.
I'd like to be your travel agent, Scott. You're here tonight. You're in Richmond tomorrow, and then you're flying out to Bradley, Illinois.
That's right,
Sunday
morning.
I'll tell you what, that's a yeoman's job by you, Scott.
Well, thank you very much. Look forward to seeing what Bradley's all about in Peoria. Going to head to Chicago and make the drive about 2 hours down to Bradley. Bradley, of course, came to Delaware last year. The Hens got a win, and the return game on Sunday afternoon. Here we go with the Bob Carpenter Center after the timeout taken by Goldey-Beacom. It's Delaware basketball. Carter just scored in the post, has it again there. Kicks out to Pinkard. Inside, they go to Carter, and 4 straight for Eric Carter.
And there's the high-low that I've been waiting for all evening. A nice kick out by Carter as he got double-teamed. Paris Ridgeway Higgs had to come off to challenge Pinkard. Pinkard with a great pass back inside to Carter. Carter doing a great job using his body to position himself.
4 in a row for the redshirt sophomore from Jackson, New Jersey. Hens up by 3. 12 seconds to shoot, and now Carter with a strip. Loops it ahead to Hayes. Can he track it down along the baseline? He does, as it was overthrown a bit. They'll reset, calming things down with 5 minutes remaining and a chance to get their lead back up. Hens led by 11 in this half. Now up by 3. Carter near corner, looking for a guard. Brings it back out beyond the arc. Mosley will call out the orders with 10 to shoot. Now 9, he brings it right side. Ball poked out of his hands. An unnecessary reach and foul by Paris Ridgeway Higgs.
Well, Paris Ridgeway Higgs was going for the steal. They had a foul to give, so to speak, and I think was probably a pretty heady play by him to try to get that steal off the screen.
It'll reset the shot clock, though, for Delaware. 4:37 left. Hens lead 52-49. Hayes on the floor with Mosley, Daly, Pinkard, and Carter. Carter, 2 of his last 2. Mosley on the wing left side. Screen comes from Carter. Now deep left side, high dribbles. He picks up his dribble. Bounce pass to Daly. Daly, a 3 off the mark, right side of the rim, and a rebound by the Lightning. Don't know if you want Daly taking that shot in that position at that point in his career.
They had an opportunity to get the ball back in deep to Eric Carter, and they turned that down for a long-range three in a close game. I think that's one where the film analysis will help.
Daly 0 of 3 today from 3, just 1 of 5 from the floor. On the dribble drive, we see Ryan Williams, who is obviously feeling better after coming out with injury earlier in this half. He'll get to the free throw line. That's team foul number 9 against Delaware, just the first on the freshman from Ardmore, PA, Daly.
Now, if you're going to let a player drive, you're almost always better off forcing him to his weak hand, or then expect your help to move in. Daly just late moving his feet in where he could have drawn the foul himself.
Thompson makes the first free throw. He sat out a big chunk of this game action with 4 fouls. He's a starter, transferred from Lackawanna College. Just 15 minutes in this one, but makes the free throw and has a chance to again give Goldey-Beacom just a 1-point disadvantage.
Foul shot blockout, always important here in these situations, Scott, especially with a high arcing shot that could rebound deep.
Corbett on the other side has missed a big chunk with only 19 minutes played because of 4 fouls. Free throw good, and here comes full court pressure. Mosley is in the game playing with 4 himself. Hayes can run the baseline as he picks it up. 4:05 remaining in the debut of Martin Inglesby. As Hayes gets it up to Bryant, crosses the timer, does the transfer from George Washington. Inside out dribble and contact too close by Shaquem Wilson. That's a foul on the Lightning. And it's a 6 on Goldey-Beacom. That'll bring us to our final media timeout. 3:57 to play. And the Hens up just 1. 52-51 in the start of the Martin Inglesby era on 94.7 WDSD.
Welcome.
How you doing?
Thanks for coming. Today you're going to choose a mobile office to drive to a remote work site.
Okay.
You can choose this Chevy Silverado that offers built-in 4G LTE Wi-Fi, or you can choose this Ford F-150 that doesn't offer Wi-Fi. But to make up for it, we added a trailer, a satellite antenna, and Dolores.
Hey, fellas.
Technology's a little behind in here.
Now, the Silverado offers built-in Wi-Fi with a connection that's stronger than your smartphone.
Slick.
So which one do you want?
I'd pick the Chevy.
Silverado.
It leaves Ford in the dust.
It just can't beat it.
And a goal, it's Delgado with his second.
Delaware 3, 1, 2, 3, Delaware!
Got the shot, and that one's in as well.
So we'll see Darian Bryant once again at the stripe where he has 3 of 4 today.
And these are very, very important foul shots. A good foul shooter. I love that play he made. He realized the Goldey-Beacom defender had really bodied him up, and he just did a nice job of turning his body and creating the foul. A very heady play from the young man from down in the D.C. area.
Bryant calmly makes both of the 1-1 free throws. Gets Delaware's lead back up to 3, 54-51. Ridgeway Higgs stopped at the center circle, gets it to Tate. Tate to Ryan Williams, now in the corner. Tate, a 3, tough angle, misses on the shot. And a rebound by Devon Pinkert to Anthony Mosley.
Good job there by Kasman Hayes' defense on a flare screen set by Goldey-Beacom. It was not called out, but he read it perfectly, got there and challenged the shot.
Here's Pinkert. Dribbles left, and that's no call. He extended his arm and pushed down Corey Tate. Could have easily been an offensive foul against Pinkert, but no whistle. Now 9 to shoot. Mosley, pass to Hayes. Hayes, cross court. Bryant, extra pass Pinkert. 4 to shoot. Pinkert inside, layup good with 2 on the ticker.
Well, Devon Pinkert did a nice job of controlling his body along the baseline and finishing using the backboard. That was a big play that Delaware needed by the senior Pinkert.
56-51, 3 minutes left at the bottom. Williams, a three, he's made one, can't make another. Tipped around, Mosley with the defensive rebound, and he'll calm things for the Hens.
And I'm not sure that was a shot that Coach Detmar wanted. That was a little too early in the shot clock. They've been getting good shots, needed a little bit more movement.
Pinker now on top to Bryant, 17 to shoot. Hens working some clock here, 13 to shoot, 2:35 to play, 56-51 is the Delaware advantage. Carter inside. Ridgeway Higgs was waiting for the charge. Carter goes around and flips it with the right hand.
We've talked about the body type that Eric Carter has, but he's very athletic and did a wonderful job there with a little scoop shot as he slid his feet to avoid the charge.
What a comeback today for Eric Carter, coming back from an ACL injury a season ago. You never know what you're going to do your first time around. He's got a double-double. Now Ridgeway Higgs inside. That's a big bucket. Getting Goldey-Beacom back within five, 58-53.
Good identification by Paris Ridgeway Higgs, understanding that Mosley has four fouls. Put the ball on the floor and attack Mosley, at least by his body position. He's got to keep it on the side and not let Higgs get to the basket with his right hand.
Those two, like you mentioned, have gone at it before at the high school level, Hodgson and Sanford. And now Delaware with eight to shoot. 1:40 to play. Mosley with five. Brings it to the right side. Pass to Pinkard. An open look for Pinkard. It gets a couple of bounces and comes off of the rim. Pushing is Williams for Goldey-Beacom the other way. Tate inside. Mosley with the foul. He tried to block the shot at the rim. And will send Tate to the free throw line where he shot 81% a year ago. And that's five on Anthony Mosley. So Delaware will play the next 87 seconds of this one. And more if it goes into overtime without their point guard.
And I think that's one of those decisions that happened so quickly. Mosley wanted to get over there and contest the shot. I think he might have been better off either trying to position himself for the offensive foul by just moving there sooner, or maybe letting the layup go, understanding that he needs to stay in the game for his ball handling more than creating a stoppage of clock and a foul situation. Now, maybe he misses both, and that will probably prove to be a good decision, but you can't count on that. I'd rather have Mosley in the game.
Absolutely. 21 minutes for Anthony Mosley, who was in foul trouble throughout. 1 of 3 from the field, 0 of 3 from 3. He made his only free throw. 1 assist, 4 rebounds. Closes the book on Anthony Mosley. Now Corey Tate at the line. Second leading scorer for Goldey-Beacom a season ago. He makes the first. Tate, City of Basketball Love Division II All-Rookie Team, CACC Rookie of the Week 3 times a year ago. And he gets Goldey with in 4. He can make it a one-possession game with his second free throw here. Does miss, though. And Carter with a rebound. That's 14 rebounds for Carter to go along with 14 points for the redshirt sophomore.
Carter has excellent activity on both ends in terms of his rebounding.
Daly, cross-court pass to Bryant. Bryant checks the game clock, checks the shot clock, and then calls a timeout. Delaware going to talk things over with a minute 10 remaining and a 4-point advantage, 58-54. And we'll stay right here as Inglesby will huddle up, call the full timeout. What are you talking about in this huddle if you're Martin Inglesby and your coaching staff?
Well, you clearly want to use the remainder of the shot clock. You don't want to shoot it too quickly here. You've got to talk about how you're going to attack them defensively, whether you maybe make a move to play a little zone here. If nothing else, you've got to do a good job of blocking out on your defensive glass, allow no second chance opportunities. And at the offensive end for this play with only 13 left, you've got to be sure you get the ball into the middle of the court. Delaware has kind of played into the hands of Goldey-Beacom by keeping the ball on the side, attacking him on the baseline. That's exactly what they want you to do. You've either got to reverse the ball quickly or get it to the high post level and then have a two-way attack, because Goldey-Beacom's tenet is keep the ball on one side of the court, make you play three offensive players versus 4.5 defenders. They've done a great job of that. That's why Delaware has only scored 58 points.
Some other scores around the CAA as it's opening night for everybody. The Citadel in Charleston. Charleston up by 4, 7 minutes left in the second quarter, 58-54 there. Drexel Trails Monmouth 76-57 on the road. Northeastern taking care of Boston University with 4 minutes left, 72-64. JMU and Old Dominion in a close one with 45 seconds left. ODU leads by 5. Hofstra close with Coppin State. 10 minutes left in that one, 52-50. Wilmington taking care of Division II Claflin 79-31, and Elon will take on William Peace in just a little bit. Delaware back on the floor, a minute 10 remaining in this one, 58-54, and the basketball will be triggered in right in front of us across from the Delaware bench. on the left side. Hayes will throw it into the backcourt to Darian Bryan. He's played very well in his debut.
Yes, he has. I've been very impressed with his versatility, especially his ball handling for Delaware.
Pinkard straight away. Puts it on the deck. Ball ripped out of his hands. Hayes saves it from going out of bounds to Daly. 1 second to shoot. Hens do not get it off. And that's a turnover. Number 18 gives it back to Goldey-Beacom.
The only good thing about that possession, they used 13 full seconds, not allowing as much time for Goldey to attack. They got the ball in the middle of the court, but again, an errant pass created the what I would call the unforced turnover.
Now 54 seconds left. Inside, Wilson working on Bryan. That's good defense by Bryan. Off the window, off the mark, and Carter a defensive rebound. 17 seconds, the difference between the game clock and the shot clock. Daly gets it across half court. He'll find Pinkert. Pinkert will absorb the contact from Ryan Williams, and that's going to be a 1-1. Eighth foul against Goldey-Beacom. Pinkert, 2 of 2 today from the free throw line, 73% a season ago. He's got 4 points on the evening.
And here's what a team like Goldey has to understand. There's a freshman who's never been to the foul line. He has the ball, and they allow him to pass it to a senior who's then fouled. I don't care what the statistics tell you. You've got to take a chance. Let's find out if the freshman can make them. I'm going to tell you over time, Ryan Daly's going to make a lot of big free throws for Delaware, but he hasn't had to make one yet.
Yeah, it would have been his first career free throw, an important point of the game. Pinkard, he shot many a free throw and made many as well, including that one. Delaware up 59-54, 38.9 remaining. Big free throw for Devon Pinkert.
Well, Pinkert's changed his style a little bit, and he's definitely getting much more arc and rotation on his foul shot. It looks much better than it did last year, Scott.
It's a beautiful-looking stroke from Devon Pinkert. Makes both Delaware up 2 possessions, 60-54. Ridgeway Higgs, baseline drive. He's cut off inside of Tillman. Tillman lays it up and through, and a timeout can be taken by T.J. Deckmar. His first game as head coach of Goldey-Beacom, talking with his team. 31.5 remaining, 30 seconds on the shot clock when it starts. So more fouls coming from Goldey-Beacom. And if you're Delaware, get it in, get it across, make your free throws. And Bart Inglesby, although maybe a little tougher than he wanted to be, will start his career 1-0.
Delaware is working hard right now on getting the line and how to get it in. That's the one advantage that Goldey has. They have such terrific guard play. They're very athletic, very quick. They do work very hard in practice on this full-court defense. They want to use it from time to time, even though their hallmark is their half-court man-to-man, keep it on the side, draw offensive fouls, challenge all shots that we've seen and talked about throughout the evening. But they do have the ability to pressure. If they do not get the steal, you'll see them foul immediately. And at this point, you probably can't wait for it to get in somebody's hands that you think statistically you want to take the chance of fouling.
Daly will be the inbounder to keep it out of his hands, at least on first pass. He'll run the baseline. Passes into Pinkert, who just made two. He's fouled by Keel, and now he'll be able to walk up the floor. Still the 1-1. That's the ninth team foul against Goldey-Beacom. Devon Pinkert, 4-4 from the stripe, and he has a chance to put Delaware back up by 6. They lead 60-56 before the free throw.
I like the confidence that Martin Inglesby showed and Ryan Daly taking the ball out in a huge time situation. Ability to run the baseline, did a nice job of getting the ball into Pinkert. That's probably exactly who they talked about in the timeout. He's in rhythm with his free throw shooting.
Pinkert, right foot in front of the left. Identical stroke to his last four. An identical result. He's made all 5 of his free throws. That one good, and Pinkard's got 7 points now, and Delaware has a 5-point lead.
And no matter who you're playing, no matter what the level of competition, to be able to make fouls in the end game will give you a lot of opportunities to play and win games for your team.
Delaware up by 6. Ridgeway Higgs, kick out Lawson. 3 ball off the mark. Hayes crashes in. That's a big rebound for Kasman. Over to Bryan it goes, and they'll chase him as he gets the ball up the floor to Daly, but the foul came first, and Delaware with 17.7 looks like they're going to survive what was a scary debut against Division II Goldey-Beacom.
And sometimes being put in this position early on is really good for your team down the road. This is a game they easily could have lost. They had to make some big plays. I thought Martin called a terrific timeout, and I believe the 10-14 mark that got the team with that open spread again. I think they moved it from 1 out to 6. Goldey cut it again, but Goldey can never get the lead, and that was the key. And I thought Delaware's done a great job of closing the game out here with their foul shooting.
Double bonus. Bryant missing. on both, 62-56 it remains. 13 seconds left. High arcing three off the window, off the mark. Rebound, Kasman Hayes, and now he'll shoot two more. As Kasman really was the player that got this one started, as everyone was off the mark, Goldey and Delaware to start this game, as both teams shot very poorly the first 10 minutes or so, and Goldey-Beacom for the entire first half, but it was Kaz who had seven in that opening stanza of the game and was the only player hitting shots in the beginning, and that's what they're going to need out of Kasman Hayes, a senior from Charlotte.
Leadership, athleticism, he's got a lot of game, he's a very versatile player. I think the thing I've always admired most about Kasman, no matter what the score, he's always played extremely hard. He is an excellent defender and, I think, an underrated rebounder for his size.
Makes the first free throw, knocks in the second as well, bouncing back from the free throw line. He missed five in a row at one point, but makes them both, and Delaware leads 64-56. 7 seconds left for Lawson, a three off the mark. Daly gets the rebound. Goldey-Beacom won't foul. And Martin Inglesby starts his career as head coach of the Delaware Blue Hens with a 1-0 record. A victory over Goldey-Beacom, 64-56. Bill, it was a game where perhaps we thought coming in Delaware would be able to take advantage of the lower level Goldey-Beacom College. Hats off to TJ Deckmar and Lee Sibley, Eric Epstein, and staff over at Goldey-Beacom for really coaching up this Lightning team. But after 40 minutes of action, Delaware wins it 64-56. They got the W to start the year for Martin Inglesby.
And let's never forget, it's hard to win. And I really feel great for Martin. This was a game that they could have lost at one point, but they found enough resiliency, some really good in-game play by Delaware. Eric Carter gave them some great minutes. They withstood the foul trouble. They withstood kind of a lot of offensive fouls. Things were going Goldey's way. They were making a lot of shots. They were creating turnovers via their defense. So a terrific effort by Goldey-Beacom. I think they've set themselves up for a wonderful season. They've got some really good players. They're very well coached, as you mentioned. And I think they're going to be a big, big factor in the CACC this year. Delaware found a way to get a win at home. They were in a no-win situation, in a sense, playing Goldey-Beacom for the first game in Martin's career. And I think they found a way to win it for the coach. And I'm very, very happy for Martin and the team.
Martin Inglesby wins his first career game as head coach of the Delaware Blue Hens against Division II Goldey-Beacom. You know who else won this first game of his head coaching career against Division II team? Mike Bray against Washington College. How about that? Both one a legend in the Delaware lore, and another hopefully on his way there after coaching under Mike Bray for 13 seasons. We're going to take a timeout. Whole lot to talk about in the Blue Hens postgame show. We'll take our first timeout, and we'll wrap this one up from the Bob Carpenter Center. 64-56, the final. Delaware 1-0 on the year. Back in a moment.